is Niches. It's a nickname for snitches. Never tell her a secret unless you want everyone else to know it.
That's not fair. I'm telling everyone what you just said.
She can't help herself. She is a serial regurgitator.
I don't know what that means, but it sounds like a bad word.
She will tell you the truth if you ask. Lord Mongus knows she can't help it and relies on her to snitch.
I can't help it.
Teach likes order and predictability. She thinks people should do what they are supposed to do and gets upset when they don't do it. She reports anything out of order to the Butterfly Council.
That's right, and rightly so.
So, it bothered you when Harold didn't build a cocoon?
Of course it did. What kind of caterpillar doesn't build a cocoon? It's the right thing to do. Harold lacks discipline.
So you reported him to the Butterfly Council?
Yes, and I told him that he was a bully, too, and needed to be disciplined.
And you flew all the way to Mexico to do that. Why?
I didn't want him to die in the winter cold.
This is stealth, who strikes fear in everyone inside and outside the dark forest. She is not evil. She's just hungry. It's not personal. It's just food.
That's right. I'm not prejudiced or judgmental. I just consume anyone in my path.
There is no love in stealth. No feelings. Just hunger. She is like a machine.
If you see me, hide. You're just a meal to me. Now I have warned you, but you know, you look awfully juicy to me.
Stealth. Stealth! She is a scary lady, folks.
Once was a bully caterpillar named Harold. He ate leaves and walked on the ground, and he refused to build a cocoon. He bullied the other caterpillars. He pushed them off leaves, and he took their eating spots.
Thank you.
One day as he was eating, a butterfly flew by him and said,
"Hello."
"Get lost! Can't you see I'm busy eating?"
"You are very big."
"You bet I am. I'm the biggest caterpillar around."
Harold had a big ego, and it looked like he thought he was the greatest. He was arrogant. That means a know-it-all. And he felt entitled to take whatever he wanted.
"I am big enough to take your food if I want to."
"I sip nectar from flowers."
"Nectar? Yuck! That is sweet stuff for wimps. I eat bitter leaves."
"Why?"
"It makes me big and mean, and I am the biggest, meanest caterpillar around."
"Wouldn't you like to be something more?"
"Hey, I get an urge to make a cocoon sometimes, but that is just weakness. I take my mind off it by playing a trick on someone."
Harold told her about a time he chewed off a leaf with the caterpillar still on it, and how the caterpillar spun on the leaf all the way to the ground, holding on for dear life.
"You should have seen the look on his face. He was so dizzy he couldn't walk on any of his legs.
He must have been scared. Didn't you feel bad after you did it?"
"Heck no! If I did, I would be weak like you. You are too wimpy to hang out with me. You are getting on my nerves. Go away."
"Didn't you feel bad after you did it?"
"No! If I did, I would be weak like you! You are too wimpy to hang out with me! You are getting on my nerves! Go away!
Go away!"
Oh!
thought about what the butterfly had said, but it bothered him, so he did some naughty things to get his mind off of it. The next day, the butterfly flew by Harold again. He thought she was beautiful, but didn't want to admit it to himself.
Hey, I thought I told you to go away.
I wanted to see you again.
What do you care?
I just care.
If you really cared, you would go fetch some food for me.
I really care, but I am not going to fetch food for you.
Thought Harold. Maybe she isn't as wimpy as I thought. That made him respect her a little, so he let her stay. And then he asked her a question because he was curious.
What's it like to fly?
Oh my, it's wonderful. You can see the world. You can fly if you really want to.
Yeah? How?
You have to build a cocoon first.
No way! Then I would change! I don't want to change! I am the biggest caterpillar around, and I can do whatever I want. Why would I want to change?
To be who you really are.
After the butterfly left, Harold had a big urge to build a cocoon. But he bullied two caterpillars instead.
Such a thing. This is totally unfair.
Not cool, not cool, not cool.
They must have found my maple syrup tar pit.
This is some kind of joke.
Yeah, get her out of here.
Maybe this is on purpose.
What do you think?
We're asking you nice. Help her out of here.
Stealth is coming.
Help us!
Mike, get down here. We need you. Can you suck up the syrup around your feet?
I'll keep my eye on Stealth alert! Stealth alert! She's coming close! Come on! Come on! You can make it!
I could kinda get used to this.
Mushy stuff! Ugh. Don't think about it!
Just goes to show, you never know when your number is up. You're not so tough, you know that?
Well, just stay off my property!
I'm sorry. Did you say something about puberty?
What?
I'll have to cut across your precious branch to get off your puberty.
That was a dangerous trick, Harold.
Who asked you?
Let me ask you a question, Bucko.
Shoot!
Are you really happy doing things like this? I mean, you don't look happy.
That's easy, Mike. I rule the roost. That makes me happy. And I'm the happiest one around.
It must be lonely at the top. But what will you have to say for yourself when all is said and done?
when all is said and done, to who?
Why, what would your mom think?
I told you before, leave my mother out of this! I don't have a mother!
Oh, I see. So the universe just spat out this plump caterpillar.
No, I got myself plump, but big all by myself!
Whatever made you act this way? Maybe you're not at fault for that. But you are at fault for not doing something about it.
Oh, so mighty mite! Are we a psychoanalyst now? Your butt is gonna need analysis after I kick it with my 18 feet!
Stealth is down there. I think she is dead.
She's not moving.
Be careful.
Hey, are you guys okay?
Wait a minute. Did I hear correctly? You appear to actually care about somebody.
No, of course not. It's just that...
Just what?
Fess up, pal. You can't take it back. You actually let some feelings slip out. After all this time, I don't believe it.
Well, don't get used to it. Everyone is entitled to a weak moment now and then. Now get off my property!
Aye, aye, Captain. Whatever you say.
Yeah, mister. You're the boss.
Maybe.
Gotta hand it to you, mate. You really suck.
Don't expect it to happen that way next time. We got lucky, pal. Real lucky.
It's not about luck, mate. Some of us suck, and some of us don't. It's all about sucking up for the ones who don't suck.
Ah, if you mean what I think you mean, it's another mean reason to make your mother proud.
I thought I told you to leave her out of this.
Good day, Harold. I have to freshen up for my date with a grub.
A grub, huh? We're really stepping up in the old world now, aren't we, old mighty mite?
Whatever.
I mean it, man. Thanks for sucking.
Sure. Anytime.
Oh my gosh! We have to save Stealth! She can't breathe! Mike, sound the alarm! Give me some backup! We're gonna help Stealth!
Help! Help!
Stealth can't breathe! We need some help!
Hold on! Should we save that bird?
Yeah, good riddance! The bane of our existence!
The deader, the better, maybe!
But look at it this way! If you save her, she'll be your friend for life! Unless, of course, you're too afraid to do this!
Hey! Who are you calling afraid?
Yeah, pal! I might help! And you felt compelled to save that bird?
Of course! Stealth can't help it if she finds us desirable to eat. She's not picking on us on purpose.
Just so we have this straight. We just helped you do a good deed, and it may come back to bite us in the butt, or even eat our butts?
I guess you could look at it that way.
When did you start doing good deeds?
Since a butterfly came to visit me.
Well, this is certainly different. Wait until all the others hear this.
I don't know what's wrong with me.
You mean, you don't know what's right with you.
Hey, my lady. You okay?
Why? Why did you save me?
This is great, Stealth. We were all afraid you weren't gonna make it.
Oh, I'm certain you were all afraid. That much we can agree on. But you haven't answered me. Why would you care one crocus breath about me?
We care about you because we're trying to be friends, of course.
Friends? Ha ha ha, what are you, deranged? Don't you know that I'd live to eat you?
We know you can't help yourself. We don't hold that against you, though.
You don't understand. I want to absolutely devour you on the spot, right here and right now. You look like food to me.
Can you wait a few hours? Or days? You've been passed out a while, and I probably wouldn't taste real good right now anyway.
Oh, don't sell yourself short, honey. A nice, fat, juicy thing like you would taste good under any circumstances.
Not when I turn into a butterfly and my wings become toxic. You wouldn't want to eat me then.
You don't know the self-control it takes to keep from eating you right now. Oh, you're giving me a headache.
You don't know how good it makes me feel that you're making the effort.
Do me a favor.
What's that?
Change into a tart butterfly so I don't want to eat you, and I want to. You look so juicy. You're a big one. You would be the biggest catch yet, and I'll tell you, I can't guarantee anything from this moment on.
I see your point, Stealth.
Get out of here! Now! Get out!
After hearing the butterfly's song, Lord Mongus makes the yellow caterpillars dance at his own concert.
I never let a chump go and pass me by. I'm a mean green caterpillar who is never shy. Give me your lunch. Morning to the evening, I'm plotting and scheming. Better ways to trick chumps, I send them off screen.
Get lost.
I'll get them all now, pretend to eat them. I'll have a good time, creating mayhem. There is no payback, I send them off track. They never come back. Being mean is all I know how to do. And my work never ends until my mischief is through.
What a chump.
I'm always alone, I don't need anybody.
What are you looking at?
I scare them away cause I don't want any company. There is no payback, I send them off track. They never come back, I never feel bad. She ain't I never would try. I'm always so sly, I'm never tongue-tied. I'll never jump high, I'll never be there. I'll never say hi, cause I don't need friends. I never will try to wish them good night. They call me Ginkgo, I'm a real stinko. I'll never mention good night to my friends. Who really needs them?
Oh,
I just deceive them. There is no payback, I send them off track. I never let a chump go and pass me by. I never let a chump go and pass on by.
Next day it rained all day. It got very cold by sundown. The butterfly flew near him just before dark.
me help you.
What can you do for me?
I can cover you with my wings.
Then you will be cold.
That's okay.
But it's so cold, you could die.
I'll take the chance.
Why?
Because I care.
There is no such thing as caring.
There is for me.
Not for me.
You could argue with me and die, or you could let me cover you with my wings.
Okay, okay. But try not to hug me or anything. I don't like that mushy stuff.
So the butterfly covered him with her wings and tried not to hug him. It got colder and colder that evening. A wind blew up, which made the butterfly hold on tighter. And it was almost like a hug. But the caterpillar did not say anything. As it got colder, the butterfly's life started to slip away.
Why are you doing this?
'Cause I care.
But why?
Because I am your mother.
In the morning, the sun shined on Harold, and the warmth of the sun woke him up. The butterfly was not there.
It figures she gave up. I had to fend for myself again.
As he looked down, Harold saw the body of the butterfly lying in the leaves below. The life was gone from her body. An early morning gust of wind had blown her off of him. He felt like he was going to cry, but he stopped himself. By the time he went to her on the ground, he couldn't help it. He started to cry. He cried and he cried. He cried for a long time. He cried so much that he cried all the meanness right out of himself. When the meanness was gone, he felt something he had never felt before. He felt real for the first time. The butterfly had loved him and hugged him until he was real. He felt a good feeling in his heart. It felt like his heart was getting bigger. And something else. He felt love for the first time. The butterfly had shown him how to love. He was bursting with joy.
Mike, are you there?
Not now, okay, lad? It's still a little early to start your fun and games.
I just want to let you know that I'm turning over a new leaf. No pun intended, of course.
And I told you, it's too early in the morning for tricks.
It's over, Mike. I'm done with my past life. In fact, I'm going to start building a cocoon.
What? Goodness gracious, what's come over you? You haven't been soaking on elderberries, have you?
No. This is the new me now, Mike. And I suppose I need to start apologizing to everyone for my previous behavior.
No, please. No apologies needed. I don't think I can handle any more earth-shaking news in one day anyway.
You're number one, Mike. Thanks for always being there.
Oh, well, forgive me if I reserve judgment until I see if this new attitude holds. That way, if you revert to being an unabashed jerk, I won't feel let down.
Suit yourself, Mike. But I won't have time for that once I start building my cocoon.
Well then, laddie, Here's to a new life.
Thanks, Mike. I've got to tell the others.
Uh-oh, get ready. He must be up to something. Here he comes.
I'm behind you all the way.
Nada?
Yes, Harold. I am still me. What are you up to?
I'm up to feeling big enough to apologize for all the dirty tricks I've played on you and your friends.
Right. What are you up to, really?
I know you probably don't trust me.
Really? Why would you think that, oh great mastermind of trickery?
Well, I have been mean to you and to everybody.
Yeah, you think?
Wait a minute. Do I hear you correctly? Do you actually care? Why should I believe you?
My mom, she came back for me. She saved me. And I was so bad, I didn't deserve it. I have feelings now. I have changed.
How do I know you won't change back? I can't trust you, Harold.
Don't believe him, Nada. It's a trick.
No. I'm going to change permanently. I'm going to build a cocoon, and I'm going to stay in it until I'm done thinking about the new person I want to be. I don't expect you to trust me. I'm going to find some way to make it up to everybody. Especially you, Nada. I know everyone hates me. I don't blame them. I have been selfish, only looking out for myself. And my mom? She loved me anyway. And maybe even you like me a little bit too, Nada?
Maybe a little bit.
Thank you.
Of course, Niches runs after Harold because she has to tell him how Nada really feels about him.
When he came out, lo and behold, he had thought himself into a big, wonderful butterfly. His wings were still wet as he looked out into the world for the first time as a butterfly. He saw a huge rainbow. It looked like a butterfly wing to him. It reminded him of his mother, and he wished his mother could be there to see it with him. Just then, exactly, rays of sunshine bounced off a dewdrop and a bright light shone around him. He heard his mother's sweet voice inside himself.
I am in the warm wind that caresses your face. I am in the sunlight that dries your wings. I will be in the beautiful friend you will meet soon. You let me love you, and now that love is yours. Inside you. Keep me in your heart and live your life well. Live your life and you live for me. Love others and you love me and you feel love for yourself. I was with you from the beginning and my love will be with you always.
Lord Mongus isn't going to like us being here. Why did you bring us here, Nada?
Yeah, Nada. We could get into big trouble.
The Blue Jay said it was Harold's birthday today. Look. Who's that with him?
I don't see anybody.
I'm not sure I see anybody else.
Yes, she is there. A beautiful butterfly. You can see right through her. She's smiling and dancing with Harold. Look at Harold, how handsome he is.
I don't know why you like him. He is such a jerk.
But he looks so different now.
He is just a jerk with pretty wings now. That's all.
You don't think change is possible? I want to change.
No, no, Nada. Lord Mongus forbids it.
You guys don't want to change?
The price of freedom is too much.
Yeah. What if we like it the way it is?
You're telling me you want to spend the rest of your lives as caterpillars under the spell of a worthless tyrant? Never to realize your full potential as butterflies? I don't believe it. You don't want to fly?
What's wrong, Nada?
Your voice is different.
Just my voice?
Well, sure.
The wings. Oh, Harold, I hope you meant what you said about making things up to me. I am in such big trouble, and I need your help.
I would do anything for you, Nada.
Oh. Anything? For me?
Anything.
Well, Lord Mongus caught us outside the forest, and he grabbed Niches and Navy and took them back. I got away, but I know he's going to punish us all, and it's all my fault for bringing them here.
I'll go talk to him.
Talk to him? Talk to him?
Yeah, you wait here. I'll be back.
So Harold visits Lord Mongus. Mongus won't let the caterpillars change, so their fear of him has paled their stripes to yellow. One brave one goes down.
Ha, ha.
He won't let us change.
Let them change.
Ha, ha.
Are you okay, Harold?
Lord Mongus beat the bejeepers out of me.
Oh, Harold.
You don't have to worry about me giving you any more crapola, Nada. I don't have any left to give.
Oh, Harold. And just when I was starting to like it.
Don't make me laugh. Nada, it hurts when I laugh. Oh.
Harold, you meant it when you said you would do anything for me?
I would, Nada.
Can we be mates, Harold?
I'm sorry, Nada. Caterpillars can't be mates with butterflies.
Oh, Harold!
What is it, Nada?
Well then, I want to be a butterfly right now. I've been saving up my web-making stuff to make my cocoon. I have enough to start right now. Yeah, that's it. Can I borrow your tree for a few days to make my cocoon? And you stand right outside my cocoon. Can you? Because you're the first one I want to... see. And oh, wait. I just got an idea.
Another idea?
Harold!
Yeah?
Harold, I can fix your wings. My cocoon stuff can fix them. Can I try?
What a great idea, Nada. Don't use too much, though. Because after listening to you just now, I really, really want you to be a butterfly, too. And I want to... See you as soon as you become a butterfly, so don't use it all up.
I think it's all fixed, Harold.
Thank you, Nada.
Harold. Harold? It's a ghost.
No, Nada. There's nothing to be afraid of. No such thing as ghosts.
Don't mean to scare you, lad and lassie. It's just me. We look cozy. A caterpillar and a butterfly, hmm?
You just got back from your date with a grub, didn't you?
That I did, and I have no problem with caterpillars and butterflies.
I'm going to change.
Is that you?
No, it's not me.
Stop fooling around, Mike. I know it's you.
Oi.
Do I look stupid? I know you glowworms have a red light and a white light.
You've played too many pranks on people, and now you are paranoid. It's not me.
Hello.
Mom? Where are you?
I am here.
I can't see you.
Only the pure in heart can see me, dear. And yours is not quite pure yet.
I can almost see you.
Don't worry, my good son. You will have your chance to purify your heart. No more yellow streak for the brave one.
Holy moly!
Moles?
It's just a saying, mate. But what are we to do about Lord Mongus? He won't let anyone change.
In unity, there is strength.
Might?
That was a remarkable experience.
Might?
This will go down in the round table journal.
Might?
Yes, my dear?
Turn on the light, Might?
Oh, of course.
What do you suppose that means? In unity there is strength. Why can't she just tell me what to do, like most moms?
Don't worry, Harold. You'll figure it out.
You know what else? I have to apologize to the snake for scaring him out of his skin. Did you guys see a naked snake anywhere?
Oh, oh, oh.
I got it! I got it!
Oi! Keep it down! I was up half the night writing in my round table journal. What is it, Harold?
In unity! Their strength in unity! We have to talk to the other caterpillars. We have to get them to help us take down Lord Mongus.
I don't know, Harold. Some of them say they like it the way it is.
No, Mike. We have to make them believe. We have to talk to them and get them in unity. How about it, Mike?
Aye, I'll help ya. I just have to report this to my journal, and I'll be ready to go.
Okay, here's the plan. When Mongus wakes up from his nap at noon, I'm gonna bombard him from above. Then, we all throw him off his tree.
Can ya tell everyone by then?
No, but I know someone who can. If I tell you something, can you keep it a secret?
Oh, no, not really.
That's good, that's good.
It is?
Maybe sometimes.
So, if I told you something, you would have to tell.
I would have to. Have to.
Even if it was wrong?
Right or wrong, no matter. Just truth and telling.
Well then, do I have something to tell you?
I'll go with her in case she might tell the wrong one.
Thank you.
Nada?
No more Nada. Now my name is Lelena.
What I'm going to say next, don't you? And yes, they lived happily ever after.
In Harold's world, it was not possible for his mother to be with him. Parents don't really give us love anyway. That's not how it works. Love doesn't come in amounts. We're already born with enough. In fact, the more you give, the more your well fills. Parents show us love, so we can tap into the endless reserve we already have. It's a rite of passage through this life. Love is not a verb or a noun. It can't be possessed. It is not an it. It may not even be of this world. It is more like who you are and where you come from, the real you. People may not feel real because you love them, but they do feel real when they love. When you are in love, you don't feel real because someone loves you. You feel real because you love them. Ever wonder why the little ones are so special? They are special because they let you love them. And when you love, you feel real. And when you feel real, you know exactly who you are. In the world of caterpillars, Harold wasn't seeing it. So in the last part of her short lifespan, the butterfly showed him. She didn't enable him. She didn't get him food. She didn't apologize for herself. She didn't give him herself to make up for the lack of his own self. She just showed him how to love in the twilight of her butterfly life. And that was what she needed for herself, for Harold.
If you are like Harold, and you are ready to become who you really are, a butterfly will come by and help you let go of the ways of a caterpillar. A transformation is not a change. It is a one-way trip. A butterfly is waiting for you. Get ready.
Oh, hi. I'm Dr. J. I was just putting up Harold, the star of our show today. Would you like to hear how I met Harold? It's kind of an interesting story. So I met Harold in Hawaii, actually. I was up alone, and my children and my wife were in bed. And I thought, well, this is nice, peaceful, quiet time, and I'll get my project done. I had another project that I had to do. And so I started to do this project, and Harold showed up in my mind. And I didn't want to bother with Harold, so I just kind of shooshed him away, but then he kept showing up. And he kept bothering me through this whole thing. And normally, when you get something like that bothering you, it's because you really want to do it. But I really didn't want to do anything with Harold. And he kept bothering me so much that I finally said, okay, I'm going to flip a coin. And if it's heads, Harold, we'll do Harold. And so I flipped the coin and it was heads. And I thought, oh man, okay, 2 out of 3. I flipped the coin twice more and it was heads and it was heads. So I thought, okay, Harold, what do you want? He wanted me to tell a story, his story. So that's what I did. Harold told me the story and I wrote it down. But Harold was still a pain, even through the story. I'm drawing these things, and you know, I don't know how to draw. And Harold says, that doesn't look like me. Make it look like me. Well, Harold, I don't know how to draw. And he started to say he was going to get somebody else, but he knew he wasn't going to be able to do that. So he said, okay, but get somebody else to draw it afterwards, okay? I said, all right. So I drew the best I could, and he was a pain through the whole thing. Make me bigger. I said, well, Harold, you're a little guy. No, make me bigger. I'm bigger than that. I said, okay, so I made him bigger. So anyway, we got done, and I published the book, and then I thought I was done with the book. And then I met Carl. I met him at the Detroit airport. He happened to be there out of all 365 days in the year. He happened to be there the same 2 hours that I was in Detroit. So isn't that a coincidence? And Carl's a macho guy. He's a Clint Eastwood, 6 foot over kind of guy, and kind of looks like Clint Eastwood. So he's not a children's book kind of guy. Well, neither is the Bully Caterpillar in a way. It's for adults too, but he's reading this book while I'm trying to tell him about something else. And so he's reading the book and all of a sudden he says, you should animate this. And then Harold, he's jumping up and down in my mind. Yeah, let's animate it. And I thought, no, I don't want to do that. I got other things to do. It's too expensive and I don't have time and I just don't want to do it. I said that to Carl and Harold. So Carl says, well, I know some people that might be able to do it pretty cheap in the Philippines. I said, well, I'm not interested. So he says, I'll call you. He gets back from the Philippines and he calls me and he made me an offer I couldn't refuse. So we decided to animate the film. It was amazing. Everything went really well. The animation turned out really good. And Harold, he's jumping up and down. And then I'm coming across this one day, I'm coming across this film festival advertisement on the internet. And I'm thinking, maybe I should enter this in the film festival. So I did. Well, we won something. And that's how it's been. You know, and my biggest problem is to get out of Harold's way so I can let him do what he's supposed to do with this film. So I'm interested to see what's going to happen next.
Thank you. was the booty caterpillar picked on everyone. And he didn't care who might get hurt, cause he did it just for fun. Harold was the booty caterpillar picked on everyone. And he didn't care what people thought, because he was the only one. Then one day his mom came along and she sat him straight away, put him in a better place, and for a brighter day. Harold was a bully caterpillar, picked on everyone, and he didn't care who might get hurt, cause he did it just for fun. Harold was a bully caterpillar, picked on everyone, and he didn't care what people thought, because he was the only one. Then one day his mom came along and she sat him straight away, put him in a better place, and for a brighter day.
Take me.